Guwahati, one of India's fastest growing cities. It isn't just the principal city of Assam. It is the gateway to the northeast, primarily because of its status as a communication hub for six adjoining sister states and Bhutan. Guwahati, not many people know, is also one of India's oldest living cities. This is evident from references made to the place in Hindu mythologies. But the allusion is to either Kamarupa or Pragjyotishpura, the city's ancient name. The Kamakhya temple here atop Nilachal Hill is evident of its prehistoric connection. Pragjyotishpura literally means light of the Orient. Historians say the area Guwahati occupies today and beyond could have earned this name because this place offered enlightenment, presumably through education. Guwahati's higher education showpiece is the Indian Institute of Technology, though the region's oldest is Cotton College. Then there is the Central Institute of Plastic Engineering and Technology, apart from a university, an engineering college, a science and technology museum, Institute of Management and numerous colleges, some of them specialized. Among the most prestigious of these institutes is Pandu College, situated on the foothills of Nilachal. The college might not be as old as a few others in Guwahati, but it stands testimony to the transition of Pandu and the adjoining Maligaon area as the heart of the railways in the northeastern India. Pandu College was inaugurated on 5th September 1962, the birth anniversary of former President Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, whose message 15 days earlier was a morale booster. The college took shape around time when the Saraighat Road-cum-Rail Bridge was being built across the Brahmaputra yonder to eventually bring the curtains down on Pandu Ghat, from where railway passengers were ferried until 1963 for onward journey from Amingaon across the river. The Pandu-Maligaon Jalukbari area in those days was like a satellite town of Guwahati nurtured by the railway. Much of the area's development has centered round the headquarters of the Northeast Frontier Railway. By the 1960s, the area had almost everything a satellite township could ask for. But locals, invariably railway employees and their kin, felt the need for a college since commuting to and from Guwahati wasn't easy then. That Pandu owes its existence to the railways is evident from the first 500 students, almost all of whom were NFR service holders. The going wasn't easy for Pandu College. It began with art stream in two bamboo-roofed rooms of Netaji Vidyapeeth Railway School, before moving on to its present location. Its founder principal Satya Kinkar Sen worked overtime with Assamese teacher Narayan Das and three others towards making what the college is today.
The college came under grant in aid scheme of the government of Assam on 1766. Before that, the college had to run purely on tuition fees and liberal donations from the public in general. The result was excellent. After Cotton College, Pandu College took its place at that time. This sapling, which was planted in 1962, turned into an oak tree today.
The tough usually get going when the going gets tough. And S.K. Sen's academic soldiers countered the initial difficulties with the unwavering support from the people around. Help from locals for their very own neighborhood Higher Education Institute complemented the strong and determined administrative machinery that has set Pandu College apart.
With the help of NFRL officers, led by Mr. B.K. Mitra, Mr. Bishigangali, M.K. Sarkar and others, they give us a good suggestion, always give us, encourage us. We feel proud, as because of teachers' sincerity and management sincerity and students' quality is proved, this college is the best in the Assam.
It took barely a year for Pandu College to add the pre-university science stream in the 1963-64 fiscal, and the three-year degree courses in arts from the 1964-65 fiscal. Science stream in the degree level took another year to be added to Pandu College's academic offerings. Bookkeeping and business method have featured in Pandu College's curriculum since inception. But it could not offer BCom course until 2005, as Guwahati University had taken a decision not to allow any other college in Guwahati to open degree course. But the college has made up for lost time in commerce, achieving in 5 what others take decades to do. Pandu College's forte in these past few decades, though, has been arts. The college has also excelled in science.
At present, 1,291 students pursuing education in TDC courses. The students' results is very good, very encouraging. Most of the students get first class in the different subjects. We have well-equipped laboratory. We have 3 hostels with all modern amenities. We accommodate 81 girl students in 2 hostels and 61 boys in 1 hostel. We have prepared our vision document for next 50 years. We try to convert this college to a center of excellence. With the next 50 years, we shall try to convert the institution into an institution of potential excellence. Enhance of sports facilities, to build an archive to preserve printing documents, traditional songs in digital form, an institute of research center for culture. We well-equipped individual faculty chamber to start research on Assamese traditional music instruments, PG in all traditional and advanced subjects and research, publication unit, installation of telephone and ATM booths, a residential medical unit, a language laboratory, inter-college orientation program for faculties, a residential complex for the faculties, and also second campus for this college to develop. With this vision, we try to nurture, to turn this college to a center of excellence with the teachers of the college, students, alumni, the guardian, all the communities, and I hope we will achieve it in days to come.
Highly efficient faculties ensuring smooth PhD and research work are the reason why Pandu College is considered a temple of higher education today.
Presently in Pandu College, 30 faculty members are holding PhD degree, and all of the teachers, most of the teachers are carrying out research. Presently we have got 27 number of minor research projects and 3 numbers of major research ongoing projects. We are pursuing research doing GIS here. And I feel in the years to come, the Pandu College, if we can continue research in this way, that it will become a full-fledged research institute.
The college is perhaps one of very few in India that has a 50-50 male-female ratio of students as well as teachers. And excels in integrity of students drawn from across the Northeast. Another reason could be that the college derives its name from Pandunath Temple, sited on the bank of the Brahmaputra nearby. It would perhaps be far-fetched to associate the college with Pandu of Mahabharata fame. But the students it churns out every year have one or more of the qualities that Pandu's 5 sons possessed: knowledge, skill, physical and mental strength, honesty, humility, and foresight.
Jyotirgamaya, the theme of Pandu College, embossed in the logo of the college, means moving towards light. For an educational institution, it can be proved by the quality of the alumni. I'm tempted to speak out about many other alumni who are occupying a very big position, not only in India, but outside the country as well. Our persons are spread over all the services. Now, those who produced all these jewels from this institute, I'd like to mention particularly the leaders, the past principals, late Shatakinkar Sen, the founder principal, Dr. Birendranath Datta, Dr. Praveen Chandra Sharma, Srinath Barman, Dr. Ratneshwar Sharma. They built the college brick by brick, taking steps for the regular development. The college owes to them for their vision.
The college's steady progress earned it a B+ accreditation from NAC in December 2003. Which was upgraded to B with a rating of 2.60 in January 2010.
The IQAC of the college was constituted on 24/9/2003. It was constituted with the objective of developing a consistent and continuous system of action to improve the overall academic and atmospheric performance of the college. Another very important performance of IQAC is to prepare the college for NAC accreditation.
The college is also the only institute in the Northeast to be associated with Pondicherry Central University for courses in 5 disciplines including MBA. This was possible due to the college's management's prudence in offering job-oriented, up-to-date courses such as computer basics, travel and tourism management, mass communication and journalism, early child care and education, human rights education, and functional English. These courses are in addition to the conventional courses. The college also organizing many national level seminars.
These lectures actually aim at to bring to light some aspects in the history of thought. As the branches of art, literature, then culture, philosophy and science.
Providing adequate backup to classroom studies is a knowledge bank. The Pandu College Library, arguably the first in the Northeast to use barcode technology for cataloging and perusal. With close to 39,000 books donated by or collected from local patrons and 70 top dailies and periodicals, the library offers special facilities to students of backward classes.
At present, we have the facility like ImpliBNet, Enlist, electronic e-resource activities through which we can get 21,000 journals and more than 50,000 e-books. We have 15 daily newspapers, 45 regional and national level journals.
In order to encourage the habit of reading, the college provides a Best Reader Award, while the Best Department Award fuels departmental excellence. But Pandu College isn't all about academics and poring over books. Its belief in physical fitness of teachers and students helped set up a multi-gym facility. The gym has catalyzed this college's achievements in NSS.
Amar torofor pora rashtriya porjayat Republic Day parade ot ongshogrohon korise amar volunteer hokole jubo mohotsobot ongshogrohon korise. Major National Integration Campot ongshogrohon korise amar disaster management program bur hoi thake adventure sports oto pandu mohabidyalayer NSS jothesto agbari ase cultural side o amar jothesto khunam hoise amar chatra chatri hokole rashtriya antarashtriya bibhinno porjayat jothesto khunam arjon korise.
And NCC.
मैं यहाँ की पांडू कॉलेज की छात्रा हूँ. मैंने एनसीसी यहाँ पे शुरुआत की. मैं जब पहली दफ़ा यहाँ पे आई थी तभी कोई भी गर्ल्स कैडेट नहीं थी. उसके बाद मैंने आरडी कैंप किया दिल्ली में 26 जनवरी अपने पांडू कॉलेज को रिप्रेजेंट किया जो बहुत ही अच्छा था और मैं अपने आप पे बहुत गौरव महसूस करती हूँ.
द कॉलेज टुक एथलेटिसिज्म एंड फिटनेस टू द नेक्स्ट लेवल बाय लेइंग द फाउंडेशन ऑफ अ सोफिस्टिकेटेड इंडोर स्टेडियम. Yoga and meditation too are pursued in the college in addition to pumping iron. Pandu College has shown the way in setting up its own water supply facility as well as generating the electricity it requires. It has also been among the first to be fully computerized. There have been many other pioneering efforts too, such as establishing women's studies cell and grievance redressal cell to handle students' complaints. But the center that scores the most is information and career guidance cell that has helped many a student chart out a successful career.
ICGC, Information and Career Guidance Cell, Pandu College, was started in 2001. With an objective to provide different information to the students with regard to different job opportunities that are available in the competitive job market. Apart from that, we make awareness among the students about their career and opportunities that are available for the future higher education. From this cell, we have been organizing different campus interview and we have been successful in placing different students in different private and government sector organizations. We have been able to produce students in different categories for art, culture and literature.
Pandu College has also molded professionals in the entertainment industry primarily because of its focus on extracurricular activities. Apart from the ambience of the college, the credit goes to a productive students' body, the Pandu College Students Union, that was formed in
1968-69.
Pandu College has thus been a picture of synergy between teachers, students and the local people it has catered to for decades. This synergy has arguably been imbibed from a highly coordinated organization like NF Railway, whose patronization led the birth of the college 50 years ago.
We have a very visionary plan and we have been preparing for that in a very different way. And Golden Jubilee will be celebrated with pomp and grandeur, and all the things will be there, from infrastructural development to visionary plans document, everything will be there in the Golden Jubilee.
The locomotive driven by excellence has ensured a golden run for Pandu College in these 50 years. The eventful journey has fueled the urge to outperform itself in the next 50 years and beyond.